Welcome back to Corey's Curious Science. In the last video, we saw a massive difference between the way a jar of water rolled down a hill and the way that a jar of golden syrup rolled. But why is it that different liquids rolled down the hill in a different way? To investigate this, I've got a new jar, but this time you can see I've got a small rock in it. And the jar is stationary on the hill. It's not moving at all. And the reason for this is that the rock inside the jar is trying to move down to the bottom of the jar. So it's applying a force which is trying to get the jar to roll up the hill. But at the same time, we've got gravity trying to pull down on the entire jar, trying to roll the jar down the hill. And at the moment, these two forces are balanced, which means that the jar isn't going anywhere. When we have our liquids, they tend to flow down the hill. And when they flow close enough down to the bottom, there's not as much force trying to roll the jar up the hill, and it can roll down a little bit until the fluid gets stuck to the side again. And then it flows down a bit further, there's less force up the hill, and it can roll down a little bit further until it gets all the way to the bottom. And of course, depending on the fluid, it'll flow at a different rate. So the thicker fluids, like our glucose syrup and our golden syrup, flow really slowly, which means that it takes a lot longer for it to seep down to the bottom so it can roll down the hill. So it rolls down slower. Whereas our water almost goes down to the bottom straight away. And this means that the water doesn't slow the jar as it rolls down the hill much at all. And as always, if you have any questions, comments, or feedback, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching and happy sciencing!